Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulihi Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. We always praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send blessings and salutations upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his entire household, his companions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless them. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us from the blessings of this beautiful day of Friday. Ameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made us such that each and every single human, they have a specified time that they are going to spend on the earth. So we always want to remind ourselves about death and about the preparation for death. For indeed, every single soul would have to leave the earth when their time is up. This is something that is certain, and this is something we should always remind ourselves about. For indeed, kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut. Every single soul shall taste death. So myself and yourselves, what is our preparation for death? What is our preparation towards death? How have we prepared for death? So how is death going to take you, and how is death going to take me? Is death going to meet us in a state or in a condition that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with us? Or is death going to meet or take us in a state or a condition in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is displeased with us? This is a very, very important question. So every Muslimah, we or they are supposed to be focused on the earth. There are so many distractions, of course, but the most important thing is that focus we are supposed to have. As people who testify that there is none worthy of worship besides Allah, and that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is his messenger, final messenger, the best of creation, the most noble of all the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is the essence of Tawheed, the belief in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you look today, death has become such that it is happening everywhere. It is happening everywhere. If I were to ask any one of us here, how many deaths or what number or how many news have you received or heard about death throughout this week? Definitely there are so many people. And this is one of the signs of the hour, one of the signs of the hour, the end of time, when death happens just suddenly, without notice. Someone you met just now, 5 minutes later, he's dead. A sister you met just now or you saw just now, 5 minutes later, she's dead. She's gone or he is gone. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us blessed death. But indeed, we have to be preparing. If you are a believer who knows death is going to come at any time, then how are you supposed to be? You are supposed to be prepared every time. You are supposed to be prepared every time. How are you going to be prepared? By engaging in so many good deeds, by being focused, just like we said. One of the things we should be focused on, as I always say, is the 5 daily prayers. Very, very important. Then what again should we be focused on? We should be focused on engaging in every form or type of good deed. Every form or type of good deed. This is another thing we should be focused upon. So that when death comes, it shall meet us in a state or in a condition that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with us. Very important for a believer, for no one knows when they are going to die. Not a single person knows the day they are going to die. Not a single soul knows the day or the date they are going to die. and not a single soul knows where they are going to die. Subhanallah.
وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَخْسِبُ غَدًا وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ.
Not a single soul knows what they shall earn for tomorrow, and not a single soul knows on which land or which place death shall meet them. Not a single soul knows the land or place death shall meet them, and not a single soul knows what they shall earn for tomorrow. And that is why you should be preparing for that tomorrow. If you look at Surah Al-Hashr, O you who believe, fear Allah, and let every soul look to what they have put forth for tomorrow.
Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu ittaqullaha wal tanzur nafsum ma qaddamat lighad.
O you who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and let every soul look to what it has put forth for tomorrow. Allahu Akbar. Let every soul look to what it has put forth for tomorrow. Very important for a believer. Every time they should be such that they are prepared. Be in this world as though you are a stranger. Be in this world as though you are a stranger. This world is no resting place. You just came here to do what you are supposed to do and you are going. You came here to do what you are supposed to do and you are going. So don't feel like this world is a place where you are supposed to settle and enjoy. There's no enjoyment in this world.
بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبَقَى.
Nay, they prefer the worldly life, whereas the hereafter is better and everlasting. Preference for this worldly life, whereas the hereafter is far better and everlasting. So prepare for the akhirah. Don't make your love for this dunya become such that you lose your akhirah in the process of trying to earn or acquire or achieve in this world. That is why we say,
رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ.
O our Lord, grant us goodness in this world as well as the next, and protect us from the punishment of the hellfire. That is who a true believer is supposed to be. Oh Allah, I want goodness in this world. I want goodness in the hereafter, and protect me from the punishment of the Jahannam. Unlike those,
فَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَن يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ.
Subhanallah. The other category of people are those who say, Oh Allah, grant us, grant us, grant us in this world, and they have no concern for the akhirah. That is a loser.
But وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ.
These are those who understand. O Allah, grant us goodness in this world as well as the akhirah, and protect us from the punishment of the Jahannam. And that is why as Muslimin and Muslimat, we say, a believer is supposed to say, Allahumma inni as'aluka husna al-khatima. O Allah, I ask you for a good ending. A good ending. Subhanallah. If someone were to die in a situation or a state where they are engaging in sin, then it is a very big problem. The angel of death comes to take your soul away at the nightclub. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. That is why very important to say, Allahumma inni as'aluka husna al-khatima. O Allah, I ask you for a good ending. grant me a good ending. Take my soul in a state or a condition in which you are pleased with me. And there is something we need to understand. When we say husn al khatima, it doesn't mean you always have to die in sujood, or you always have to die in the masjid, or you always have to die whilst reciting the Quran. It doesn't mean. You may be killed just like that. You die as a martyr. It is a blessed death. You may die in a car accident. It could be a blessed death. Last year, we heard about the death of one of the Qurra in Sudan, Sheikh Muhammad Nuruddin or Nurain As-Siddiq, who passed away in a car accident. Everyone knows that Qari for goodness. And imagine, with all the goodness and everything, Allah chose to take his soul away in a car accident. So it doesn't mean husn al-khatima must not always be in the masjid or whilst reciting the Quran or the way we think it to be like. The most important thing, you yourself, judge yourself. Do what you are supposed to do and be ready at every time, any time that death can come to take you. So when you die, in any condition you see yourself in, that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for you. You have no choice over death. And that is why when death comes, لا يستأخرون ساعة ولا يستقدمون. When it is time for one to leave the earth, it cannot be delayed for an hour, nor can it be postponed. Time is up, time up. When you play the football match, for example, 90 minutes, they tell you extra time. Correct? They tell you extra time, maybe 1, 2, 4, 5 minutes, sometimes 8 minutes, depending on the coach, depending on what he does. But when it comes to death, there is no extra time. Time is up, time is up. Time is up, your time is up. No, لا يستأخرون ساعة ولا يستقدمون. It would not be drawn back for an hour, neither will it be postponed. So we are supposed to be preparing at every moment. We think to ourselves, am I ready for death? If death comes now, am I ready? And be a good person, for indeed, when you die, the angels would come to where you stay and they would do a survey to hear what are the people saying about this person. What are the people saying about this person? And when they do the survey, they would go back to Allah. Even though Allah knows, they will tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is what the people are saying about that person. And if they say good about you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would take that good. And you would be judged by that. He would look at you with that picture. If they talk evil about you, then there is a problem, because that is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would look at you as, or take you as. There are people who, when they die, people are happy. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. You die, people are happy. People are supposed to pray for you, but they are happy. This man is gone, now we can have peace. This man is gone, or this woman is gone, now we can have peace. In this dunya, what is going to be happening to that person in their grave? What is going to be happening to that person in their grave? So we are supposed to really fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا كَسَبَتْ وَهُمْ لَا يُزْلَمُونَ. And fear the day in which you shall be returning to your Lord, and every soul shall be paid in accordance to what they earned, and no one shall be wronged. Justice shall be done to everyone. وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا كَسَبَتْ وَهُمْ لَا يُزْلَمُونَ. We always hear this, for example, on a Friday, when the Imam is doing his khutbah. It is a very important reminder. Every soul should prepare for the day they are going to be returning to their Maker. No one is going to be wronged. You shall be paid in accordance to what you earned. People can badmouth you. They can say whatever they want to say. No problem. It is between you and Allah. Don't ever disturb yourself about what the world is saying about you. You know what you are aiming or preparing your focus. Just be focused. Sometimes you are trying your best to become a better Muslim. People begin to come, they badmouth you, and they say you are an extremist. Don't worry yourself. Don't worry yourself. Let them say whatever they want to say. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was called so many things. Different types of things he was accused of. What about yourself and myself? What about yourselves and myself? So we really don't need to bother. By the way, they are not going to be the ones to judge us. It is between us and Allah. So be focused. Prepare for death. For indeed, we don't want to be like those whom when death comes, they say, nay, I wish I can be returned back to the earth. For as-saddaka wa akum min as-salihin.
وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا وَاللَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ.
The verse before this one is Surah Al-Munafiqun.
وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولَ رَبِّ لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ.
And spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from what you have earned or from what we have granted you before death comes to you. And then you say, oh, I wish I can be returned back to the earth for a saddaqa, so that I can give charity or spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa akum min as-salihin, and so that I can be from among the righteous or from among the good ones. So no one wants to regret the small time we have. So in fact, this is one of the ways through which we should be preparing for death. Give charity so that when you die, even whilst you are in your grave, you shall continue receiving a reward. Sadaqa jariya, the knowledge which people benefit from through you, and when your children pray for you. Righteous child that prays for their parents when the parents die. رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. Oh Allah, have mercy on them because they are the ones that brought me up. Oh Allah, have mercy on them because they are the ones that brought me up. رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. Have mercy on them because they are the ones that brought me up. Pray for pious children, righteous children, so that even whilst you are in your grave, they shall continue to pray for you. It is far better than fighting for the will or the inheritance of the property of the dad. Your dad is in your grave. Sometimes it is so unfortunate. The day the dad dies, in the graveyard, already people are arguing about the distribution of the property. Subhanallah. In the grave, he would be put inside his grave. The angels are going to come. You are not bothered about what condition your dad is going to go into. Rather, you are bothered about the estate or the farm he has or some other things he has left in terms of property. That is why sometimes it is good when one leaves this earth, they leave minimum property. We're not saying you... No problem, you can have as much as you want, but sometimes due to the kind of time we are in, those who leave few things, there is always less chaos and less crisis in the home. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on all those who've passed away. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy on all those who've passed away, really. So really we should be preparing for death. I just said charity is one of the ways through which we can prepare for the day we shall be meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that even when you are no more, you continue to gain a reward. We said sadaqah jariyah, we said knowledge which people benefit from through your means, or whether you taught, or through your means, and children who would pray for you when you are no more. These are three things that continue to run even after one leaves the earth. Even after one leaves the earth. So this world is just for a short time. It is like a clockwork. It starts from 12, it moves. When it gets back to 12, time up. So, what do you have? You have the time range of the movement before, or the movement of the initial 12 to when it rounds over again. So that time is the time you have to prepare. Man ahabba lika'a Allahi ahabba Allahu lika'ahu. Whoever loves the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah loves to meet them. Imagine, Allah wants to meet you. Allahu Akbar. Your Lord, Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal. When someone, a celebrity, a rich person, a top shot in the any part of the dunya, anything, maybe football, maybe a scholar, maybe a king, a governor, a minister, a president, when they want to meet you, imagine they say, I really want to meet this person. How would you feel? You feel like a VVIP. Imagine the Lord of the Samawat and Ard, he wants to meet you. What type of a VVVIP is that? The V has no limits, subhanAllah. Your own Lord wants to meet you. It is very important we prepare. It is very important we prepare so that when we are no more, people will remember us for the good we did whilst we were on the earth. No one should be happy when you are no more. People should pray for you when you are no more. So it's very important, don't be such that you make people's lives difficult. Remember, one day you are going to die. Be a simple person, be a humble person, be a normal human being. Be such that you respect everyone. Don't make people's lives difficult. Wallahu fi awni al-abd ma kana al-abdu fi awni akhihi. Man yassara ala mu'sirin yassara Allahu alayhi fi dunya wal akhirah. Allahu akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to be in the assistance of a slave for as long as that slave or worshipper continues to be in the assistance of his brother. And whoever helps one who is in need, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps them in this world as well as the next. وَمَنْ سَتَرَ مُسْلِمًا سَتَرَهُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Whoever shields or covers or hides the misdeed of a person, a worshipper, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would do the same for them. That brother has died, the sister has passed away. You know something bad they did, only you know. What is the benefit of you coming and telling the entire world after they've left? Or even whilst they are here? Be a person who has trust. Be a person who has trust. The same way, if you do something really bad, dirty, nasty, filthy, disgusting between you and Allah, and you seek for forgiveness and Allah forgives you, on the day of judgment, no one would know. It is between you and Allah. The same way you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shield your misdeed, don't expose people. Don't expose people. Don't do that. there's no benefit. You are not going to achieve anything, because by exposing them, you haven't done anything in terms of making them become better. Neither did you advise them, nor are they going to change. You did nothing. In fact, you are gaining sin for yourself. Rather, think of ways that the person becomes a better person. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us blessed death. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take us in a condition or state in which He is pleased with us. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد سبحان الله وبحمده سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.